The following is a presentation of the Matt Talk Podcast Network. It's time for Inside Virginia Tech Wrestling. We'll talk all things Hokie wrestling with Coach Tony Roby and staff. Now, let's join your host, Hall of Fame wrestling writer and broadcaster, Jason Bryant.
A víťaz som zlatej medaily v kategórii 74 kg vyhráva Levis z USA.
And gold medal winner in category 74 kg is Levis from USA.
Lewis been extremely proficient with his leg attacks, actually has shown real improvement in his parterre game, which again is less than a year old. Abakarov, 10th at the Junior European Championships, but again, the European Continental Championship is, it's loaded in terms of sometimes you can draw the champ right off the bat, they can have a bad day, just like you can here, but no easy draws at the European, so. 30 seconds in. And a lot of motion. Passivity being offered against Red, 50 seconds in. That will be confirmed. That's the first warning against Mekhi Lewis. Shot by Abakarov. Sprawl here by Lewis. Trying to peel that underhook to the near side. Both wrestlers back up to their feet. Abakarov controlling the center of the mat. Snapping and spins. Bakarov trying to make sure that Mekhi Lewis cannot wrestle from space. Passivity being offered and confirmed against Lewis. He will go on the activity period. 30 seconds to score. He'll be penalized 1 point for passivity. Nice shot there by Abakarov. Lewis trying to post the hand to the mat. 15 to go on the activity period. And the activity period has expired. 1 point for Abakarov. He has a 1-0 lead on the passivity. A minute to go here in the first. Running high C attempt, snap and spin attempt by Lewis. Attack, shot, reshot, covers, gets the 2-point takedown. Mekhi Lewis will take a 2-0 lead, goes, tries to go right to that lace. As we go out of bounds, 3:40 to go. That's 40 to go here in the period. Good counter offense there by Lewis. Under 20 to go. First period still a 2-1 lead for Lewis. Trnava, Slovakia, City Sports Hall. Jason Bryan here with you. Presentation of the Junior World Championships by United World Wrestling. And to the break, 2-1 lead for Mekhi Lewis over Abubakir Abakarov of Azerbaijan. Final day of competition here in Trnava. Two-day format now. As last year, the cadets used the two-day format as essentially a test event through their series and their qualifications in Continentals. So they wrestle half the weights on the first day. The end of the day, they will wrestle the semifinals. Those winners will come back and wrestle the following night in the championship. So semifinals were last night. And back to action. Abakarov getting extended on the shot. Lewis trying to reach through and grab the far ankle on the sprawl. And what Abakarov has been taking shots. He is at a low percentage at the moment, but he's not afraid to shoot. Heavy inside collar tie by Abakarov. Heavy collar tie here. Lewis creates some space. Abakarov doing a good job at controlling the center. Shot from space again. Lewis counters. And he's going to drive the action out of bounds. 1 point on the step out. You saw what Abakarov tried to do. He got to the zone. He dropped to his knees. He tried to make sure it looked like he was grounded and not give up a point. He was not successful in that tactic. And a 3-1 lead now for Mekhi Lewis. 2 minutes to go here in the bout. Referee telling Abakarov to get his head up. Abakarov with a height advantage and a length advantage. Oh, nice drag. Lewis stays away from it. Coming up on the 1 minute mark. Referee now telling Lewis to get his head up. We are under a minute. Neither wrestler's really taking a shot in the last minute or so. Lewis clears the collar tie. Abakarov trying to use that underhook to his right side. Forty to go. Head-to-head collar ties. Shot by Abakarov. He's on the leg. Tries to double off. The body. Lewis is going to throw it by and throw it out of bounds for one. Tremendous mat awareness by the freestyle novice. Almost a collective sigh in this building from the Russian, from the Azerbaijan contingent. Look at there! Caution and one as there was a little bit of an uppercut. Now the mat chairman. Caution and one for Lewis. Five to go. The caution and one. Lewis circling. Three, two, one, and world champion. The lunch pail shown up in Trnava. 5-1 victory at a junior world championship for the United States of America, Mekhi Lewis. We promised you would bring you on location an episode of Inside Virginia Tech Wrestling from Slovakia, and we did do it sitting here at the Team USA dinner after the team finishes in second place. But for Hokie Nation, the big story, Mekhi Lewis wins a junior world championship, the U.S.'s third straight at the weight class. Mark Hall, previous one, the previous two. Now Mekhi stepping right in, winning a title at the weight class. We'll open it up with Jared Frayer. You spent a lot of time working with this guy. These leg laces come out of nowhere. I mean, what's it been like the last couple months since he's made the team and then finally seeing it come to fruition?
He's a sponge. He gets better every day, wants to get better every day. We have to pull him off the mat, and, you know, that's not just saying that. I mean, he legitimately wants to be in the wrestling room 24/7. So the leaps and bounds that he's made over the last 6 months, really just learning the sport of freestyle, you know, really teaching him to not think about it being freestyle. The way he wrestles, whether it's folk style, freestyle, is the way he always needs to wrestle, and just let it go. Be him. Coach KJ kind of all week was do what you do and not worry about the other guys, and that's really what it takes, and I think you saw that tonight.
Mekhi, I think everybody on Tech sideline has been asking me, it's like, all right, well, the first question you got to ask him, do you like freestyle now?
It's okay. It's good. I like it a little bit more now. I'm getting used to it, adjusted to it. So, yeah, it's starting to grow on me.
Talk a little bit about what you were expecting going in. First time you've ever been overseas. You got the passport stuff taken care of. You draw Estonia in round one. Not exactly a freestyle powerhouse. When you get that type of draw, what does Coach Frayer tell you how to prepare? I mean, what is the mindset going into the very first match of any international opponent you've ever wrestled?
It was just to have fun, wrestle hard, wrestle with confidence, and just believing in my technique and everything that they taught me, and that basically I was going to be fine. And the whole time going out there with that same mentality for every match, and that's why I think what helped me the most, just realizing that I just need to wrestle hard and have fun.
Frayer, when he says he wants to wrestle hard and have fun, What was it like watching him wrestle hard and have fun out there? I mean, you beat you got to draw with Estonia and South Africa before you get to the semis. I mean, you got to like that right off the bat too.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of a double edged sword. It's not a good draw unless you make it a good draw and take care of business, and that's what he did. He went out there and got the job done. Quick tech fall and a pin in the first two rounds, and then, you know, knowing the Mongolian guy was pretty darn good, he you know, put the pedal to the metal and took care of business against the Mongolia. Before we
start meeting, here's KJ talking. Let's listen in.
I'm gonna say grace, and then our world championships, our Olympic golds, our NCAA titles are still in front of us, and so we just need to keep grinding. But I'm gonna let Coach, which one of you guys wanna go first? I'm gonna let Coach Steve go first. I'll let Rob go, and then I'll close us out. Unless anybody else has anything they want to say.
I'll start off and just echo what Kevin said. Athletes, number one, congratulations for getting to the World Championships and competing here. Those of you that are leaving with medals, an awesome experience to be with you guys. Those that maybe aren't leaving with some hardware, I hope it just fuels your fire moving forward. Parents, awesome group of kids, right? I think this is so important that we make sure parents know that you guys have raised these guys right. Throughout all of the training camps that we had and on this trip, we as coaches appreciate the fact that we can teach them, train them, travel with them, and they represent themselves well. They represent their universities well. They represent our sport really well. And that's a kudos to you for raising them right and making sure they understand how they should represent themselves and the country. That's really big. In terms of details, look, it's no mystery to anybody. Look at our past junior world teams. Those are the guys, a lot of the times, that are representing us at the senior worlds years later, that are representing us at the Olympics. It's a direct equation, right? And for those of you that are leaving here, got your hand raised, and you got the success that you wanted, understand that it's a stepping stone, right? And we keep echoing this, but be willing to go home from this success or a little bit of a shortfall, and be willing to look at yourself and say, what does my wrestling need, right? For you as an athlete, you know when you stepped off of any of the matches that you wrestled, there's something that you can improve on. Now, do you just step off the mat and just say, you know what, that match didn't work out for me, or I'm doing things well, I'm good with where I'm at, I don't need to make changes. Anybody that has seen this sport at this level understands that the next time you step on the mat, you better up your game, right? You better figure out the areas that you're going to fix, and the areas that you're doing well, how do you sharpen them and make them a little bit better? So from an overall standpoint, again, from getting a chance to go through the camps with these guys and be here with you, it's just a huge, I give a big thanks to you guys. Being able to step on that podium and bring home a second place team trophy, I love the fact that we come to a place like this and we're happy with a second, but we're not satisfied with a second, right? And my hope for you guys is as you move forward, as you set new goals, and you set new aspirations, be willing to do what you've done up to this point and then take it a step further, right? So the Olympic titles, the world titles that can be in front of you guys, it's all about what you're doing with every single day. So, again, just a big thank you to you guys. This was awesome for me to be a part of. And I do hope that I get to work with you guys in the future. Even though we may be on opposite mats, other sides of the mats here moving forward in the months to come, it's awesome to be over here and represent our country and you guys be the poster children of what wrestling is in the United States. So thank you guys for letting me be a part of it.
Hey, feel free to dig into that pizza, but keep your eyes on guys speaking. I know sometimes we get locked in on our food, so let's make sure we're paying attention here. But feel free to dig in and we'll keep this thing going. Rob.
Well, I mean, I can't say much more than what Teague and Coach just said. So it has been a pleasure, coaching these young men and getting to know everybody and meet the parents and whatnot. And again, just echoing what Teague said, parents, awesome, awesome kids, man. These boys are, young men are awesome. Great to coach, very open to being coached. Always wanting to learn, very respectful, and again, representing us, your families, and the country at the highest standards. As you've seen some of these teams compete, you know, there's some dirtiness that goes on, and you know, in Aaron's match and a couple other matches, you know, some headbutts and things like that. We can't, the boys handle themselves perfectly, stayed on track and whatnot, stayed focused. Coach KJ and I have been on a lot of great teams in years past. And, you know, we've talked a lot on this trip. And I tell you, man, the future is bright. And you guys are that future. Again, win or lose, you know, absorb everything, learn from it. And we can only get better, right? I mean, we can only get better. So, again, it was a pleasure to be on this trip. I was a little – when Kevin texted me, and said, hey, congrats, you're coaching the junior world team. I'm like, that's great. I don't remember actually putting in for that assignment, to be honest with you. So I actually had to look. I joked with him. I texted him back. I said, men or women? Like, I didn't even know if I was coaching the men or women team. And he's like, women. Or he said, men. And I said, that's great. I'm like, where are we going? Slovakia. I didn't even know that was a country. You know, so I was a little hesitant to be on the staff. And now I can't imagine not being on the staff. For his involved and getting to know everybody, it's been great. And again, I can't echo enough of what Teague said, so I'm not going to take too much time, eat your pizza, but again, I appreciate it. Thank you very much for letting me be a part of this this team and this success. And go Jersey, right? I'm from, or I live in Jersey, so.
Anyways. Line of questioning was interrupted by, as you heard, Teague Moore, Rob Eider say a few words. KJ, Coach Kevin Jackson finished off with some words as well, talking about the world champs that are leaving us and such. But picking back up on Inside Virginia Tech Wrestling, talking to Jared Frayer, Makai Lewis. Jared, you've had quite a lot of international experience. We've gone through this in the previous couple episodes and talking about, you know, your preparation, coaching Makai, Makai's preparation, listening to you as a coach. Now that the journey is done, what was the most gratifying thing for you to see from an athlete from a coach to an athlete?
You know, especially in these situations, I think it's the relationship that you build, and these situations that, you know, you just would never have domestically. You know, the little things that, you know, were silly to think about and bring over, you know, being able to cook ramen and tuna for him, having him eat applesauce and things that, you know, we just silly things that you know, we're able to bond over and travel. And, you know, we found this restaurant between the two of us. We were getting risotto and just a cool experience, a week in a foreign country. I mean, it was something special. And for it to all come to fruition tonight was you know, something that I'll never forget and I'll cherish. And, you know, I just appreciate, you know, Makai letting me have this opportunity and grateful for it. And just the SCRDC and Coach Roby, you know, allowing us to come over here and do what we do. So pretty special.
Risotto, that's one thing. I really love risotto. I had some the other day. But Makai, had you ever had risotto prior to this trip?
Pizza?
Risotto is like the rice stuff.
No. No. I never did that.
What was the best thing you ate here in Slovakia?
Probably that.
When we look back at what's going into this season, David McFadden will be on the U-23 world team. It's a real big thing for Virginia Tech. And what's it mean to go through this journey? And, you know, when he's you know, in a month, 2 months, is going to have the same opportunity you did. You can go back and say, yo, I just did this. You can do this too.
Yeah, basically to tell him that, and just to remind him to have fun and just to enjoy the moment and embrace everything. So all of that, and just go out there and wrestle. So
what was it like experiencing that? I mean, what was it like when you hear the first few bars? Cause they don't play the whole anthem here at the junior worlds for some reason. But when you hear that, dun, 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 what goes through your mind when that flag is up there and you're on the top of the podium?
That I actually won. and that I represented my country good. And I'm pretty sure a lot of people are proud. So just hearing the national anthem play, was pretty big. I liked it.
A lot for Hokie Nation to be proud of you in terms of what your performance. Now, going into the season, how do you think this sets you up mentally for the season? I mean, it's a different style of wrestling, but, you know, you guys got to replace some points. You're in the lineup. You've got high expectations. Now you've even got probably higher expectations because this isn't a national. This is a world championship. This is, you know, there's not a whole lot of U.S. junior world champs. You're on that list.
Just to wrestle with confidence and having fun. Just always remember to have fun. And, like, don't get caught up in all the talk and what people got to say. Just stay focused on what I got to do and what I got to accomplish. And just making sure that everybody is
Hold on, KJ's talking. We'll get KJ.
5:45 be in the lobby. AM. That's 8 p.m.?
No, just say AM.
5:45 AM, be in the lobby, backpack, ready to go. All right? Everybody got that?
Got it.
Don't get left in Slovakia. Don't get left.
That's also a lesson. Don't get left in Slovakia. So, 5:45 AM. I joked with Frayer on the last episode about Slovakia knowledge. What have you learned about the country of Slovakia since you've been here? Other than your first foreign country. You know, my first foreign country was Azerbaijan, and I was with this guy, with Frayer on that trip. I mean, what'd you learn?
A lot of people stare. Because every time I was with Frayer walking around, a lot of people here were staring at me. I don't know if it was good or bad, but I noticed that. And I also noticed that they take soccer really serious out here. And, like, you can't walk or say the wrong things about certain teams because it's a lot of fans and they will come after you. So I learned that, too.
Yeah, you said you saw, like, this monstrous brawl. Okay, so let's set the stage here. So Spartak Trnava is in the – it's in what is, I believe, the Super League. I'm not a – I'm going to use the term football, even though it's pretty much everything against everything I stand for because we got football. And so the European style of football, we've got that. And they're in a league, the National League, and then they won the league last year, so they got promoted to, like, what is the Europa League. So they hosted their first Europa League match against, like, I'm not sure who they even playing. It was on Thursday. Well, I went to the game on Saturday, and it wasn't really rowdy, but it was cool. But this International League is a whole other deal. Frayer, why don't you just explain a little bit about the soccer culture you witnessed here in Trnava?
Yeah, just, I mean, we took it, we wanted to get our sightseeing duties out of the way before the business was at hand, and so as we're taking the taxi to the stadium, we heard there's a mall there, and really wanted to kind of take it all in. And we're seeing all these cops. I mean, there's cops on every corner dressed like RoboCop. I mean, they're all decked out. They got shoulder pads, knee pads, elbow pads, helmets. So they're ready to. It looks like they're ready to go to battle. So we get dropped off. We get ourselves lost a little bit, but we find the sign that we're looking for to take our picture in front of, and then we figured out it's time to go back to the hotel. So as we're waiting for the taxi, which we now know in the country of Slovakia, you can only call a cab. You can't just hail a cab. So we hailed a few cabs, and as we were sitting there waiting for a cab to hopefully, you know, give us mercy and pick us up, 50 guys come running out of a bar, and 50 other guys meet them at the corner like a West Side Story. It was straight out of a movie.
I was like, maybe the Outsiders, you know, the greasers and the I don't even remember. That's eighth grade.
Them, but that's yeah.
Socials, yeah. Eric Guerrero with the clutch move there.
So they get out and they battle for 30, 40 seconds. I mean, it was straight out of a movie. It was unbelievable. You know, beer bottles coming from one side, punches thrown. It was intense, and we were scared a little bit. I was kind of excited about it. Mekhi was mad that his phone wasn't on, so he couldn't get on Snapchat. But yeah, we took it in, and then all the cops came flying in there and broke it up, and they all took off running. So hooliganism is alive and well in the town of Trnava.
We circle back to Mekhi a little bit about how the season, you know, the lineup being the way it is. Is this kind of solidify that weight class decision a little bit better? And okay, you're up, you're healthy.
Yeah, no, I think, you know, it's Mekhi is green. He gets better every day. He's got so much wrestling to learn, and he's already a junior world champion. So for him to be limited by weight cutting and it'd be a cut to make 57, and he wouldn't be a comfortable guy for 4 months. But the ability for him to wrestle at 65 and get better. Because his goal is to win NCAA titles. Obviously, more world titles are down the road for him. But, you know, his there's a reason he's 6 out of 10 liking freestyle. It's because he's 10 out of 10 in folk style and wants to win NCAA titles, and that's plural. So it's his decision, and it's a decision that we all think is the best decision. And him and McFadden are going to make each other better and are going to push each other to titles, NCAA titles.
Mekhi's being your first trip, your first national team experience. What was the whole process like with the training camps? I mean, who did you really feel like you bonded with as a teammate and maybe even a national team coach that really kind of maybe opened your eyes a little bit to the world of, you know, USA Wrestling specifically?
Well, I bonded with a lot of teammates. Let me think. Yeah, I got along with Brooks and Demas, Dom. I love Dom. He's so funny. So funny. Who else? I'm trying to think.
You're still kind of taking it a moment. I mean, has it really hit you yet?
No, like it hasn't. I'm like getting notifications on my phone Well, people just back home congratulating me and stuff. It's crazy. Like, I'm just grateful. I'm going to keep saying that I'm grateful for it. So, yeah, I'm grateful. Oh, and also, Coach Teague, I think, helped me out with, all right, the Ravens are winning. Let's go. That's my football team. But Coach T helped me out with a lot, just being confident at the training, like, at the training center and stuff. And I think that's what helped me when it came to, like, being out here for the experience and stuff, too.
Any final words, Jared Frayer? As we're going to have a pretty elaborately produced episode here. So, we've got... I got a lot of stuff to add in, as you've heard in the opening of the show. That's the things that I was talking about, you know, as recording this stuff on location. This is, like, I think the seventh show we've done over here, but just what an experience, man.
What an experience. I mean, I was out of wrestling for 3 years, and to be on this stage, and Mekhi's talked about it earlier, it's just it's a special moment, and to be around, you know, my brothers like Kevin Jackson and the guys that I was with for so long, for so many years on the national team, and to be able to coach a guy that goes out there and doesn't know any better. He's just going to go out there and win and find a way to win, and has the grit and the pride to do what nobody thought he could do. Flow Wrestling didn't even have him in their top 10, you know, supposed to do well at the World Championships, and he goes out there and just crushes it. So super proud, excited, and thankful.
A little inside baseball on you, too, because I texted Jared before the tournament, making sure I could at least do this, because I promised we were going to do a show from here. And I was like, all right, hey, you know, win or lose, where can I meet you? And you're like, lose? We're going to win. I mean, you called this like the moment I saw you here. So you were confident. One thing I also want to talk about, Mekhi, is Coach KJ brought it up in his speech that we decided to not record just because of, you know, some things are for the team, some things are for the team. You took a shot in the face that was not the cleanest wrestling move anywhere in the world, actually. How do you keep your composure in that situation? This guy is obviously flustered, and he just wails up an uppercut. I can't even think of the term. Uppercut you right in the face. And you're just, I mean, you took a little exception to it, but how did you maintain your composure in that moment?
Basically, I just remember that I was winning, so I don't got to do anything. Sorry that you're mad that you're losing, but I'm fine. I'm okay. I mean, I had to get in his face to let him know, like, I ain't going to just back down and let him think that he going to just, you know, be able to sneak one in. Like, we could go if you really want to, but I don't think you want to do that. But keeping my composure is just basically, like, once it happened, I was just like, all right, it happened. But, like, you still lost the match, so... what you got out of it, because it didn't hurt, so.
Yeah. I know the international sign to respond for that. What is it, Frayer? It's called?
Scoreboard.
Yeah, exactly. Point at the scoreboard. He took it like a champ, and you know, it didn't affect him. His emotions were in check, and it's a big deal. That's why he's the champ.
I also want to thank all of Hokie Nation for tweeting at us during the course of the tournament. I know Jersey Hokie is always on there. George Rogers is always on there. And, you know, the folks from TechSideline.com who have went from not having a wrestling message board to now having a dedicated wrestling message board. Hokie Nation has gone crazy about wrestling. I'm just glad to be along for the ride. So, Mekhi, Jared, thanks for making it at least a fun one to call, at least from an American perspective.
No doubt. Go VT.
Hokie fans, listen to Inside Virginia Tech Wrestling anywhere you go by subscribing on Apple Podcasts. Go to InsideVirginiaTechWrestling.com/iTunes, or you can get the exclusive Android or iOS apps by going to InsideVirginiaTechWrestling.com.
This show is part of the Matt Talk Podcast Network. For more wrestling podcasts, head over to MattTalkOnline.com.